Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. Let's get started with our first question. James Q asks, Dear Blocko, what if everyone went to sleep at the same time? Well, if everyone in the world decided to completely sync up their bedtimes, things would get pretty weird. To begin with, certain portions of the world would be sleeping during daylight hours. This would not only disrupt their natural circadian rhythm and sleep-wake cycle, but would force them to work at night, making outdoor jobs like construction and agriculture very difficult. This regimented sleep time would also affect energy production and carbon dioxide emissions. While everyone is asleep, power grids would feel a sigh of relief, and emissions would decline. But when everyone wakes up around the same time and starts using their lights and appliances, emissions would surge due to all of the power stations firing up, something critics of Earth Hour have pointed out. And with people up and working at night, we would use more electricity for lighting than the 232 billion kilowatt hours the United States already consumes yearly for homes and buildings. Right now, this only accounts for 6% of the country's total electrical use. Who knows how big this percentage would grow if the world adopted the same sleep time? Interesting question, though. Thank you for asking. Michaela H. asks, Dear Blocko, why do people get car sick? People that feel sick or nauseous when traveling by car, airplane, or boat are all suffering from motion sickness. This happens when there is a conflict between what you are seeing and what your body is feeling. While the car is moving, your inner ear, which is responsible for your sense of balance, feels your motion. But if you are looking at your phone instead of out the window, your eyes don't register the movement. This mix-up can result in feelings of dizziness, cold sweats, nausea, and vomiting. All of that is bad stuff. But now for some good stuff, it's time for questions about me and my world. Galaxy World asks, Dear Blocko, what would you do if you encountered an alien? Alien emoji. Well, I've actually encountered a lot of aliens. Many aliens visit the Lifenoggin world. Some are evil, some are nice, others are made of spiders. And those are a little harder to love, for obvious reasons. Circlea does a great job of fighting off the bad aliens, though. She's great. Rice Rat asks, Dear Blocko, have you ever had any wars in your world? I don't think so. Actually, come to think of it, we did have a small scuffle with a group of alpacas, but they started it. They were just looking at me funny, you know? They're just weird, okay? They're weird looking. Anyway, do you have any questions about your world or my world? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. And if you're feeling up to it, follow me on Twitter and Instagram as well. Wanna watch another episode of Dear Blocko? Check out this one we did. Well, first off, when people talk about a person's intelligence quotient, or IQ, they're usually talking about a score they got on some tests that are thought to measure a person's cognitive abilities, or intelligence, compared to other people in their age group. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Lifenoggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.